So here we are, we're in Mount Gambier. We have 52 floats, I believe, which will be coming down a little bit later on. I think we'll be starting at around about 11 a.m. local time. Of course, I think there's a clock under the video player that's telling you what the time is in New South Wales, which is interesting but uninformative. Well, somewhat informative, but maybe not interesting is what I'm trying to say. So we will be covering that when it happens. In the meantime, we have a lot of other interesting things going on, such as miniature steam trains, as we wait for the Christmas parade to start. Of course, we are live streaming directly into Facebook, and a big thank you to all of the people involved and our partners for assisting getting this live stream up and running. A special thank you to Mount Gambier City Council, as well as the Lions Club. A big shout out, of course, to Alan Woodham, who's one of the main driving forces behind this entire event, described by many as perhaps the biggest parade in Australia, emphasis perhaps on the perhaps. So we will have 52 floats coming down a little bit later on, I can tell you. We'll be starting with the Mount Gambier City Band. And we'll have a float from Win TV. And we'll have the Nutcracker float, the Country Christmas and Ararat City Band, just as we start off. So a lot of fun to come up later on today. And of course, we will be live broadcasting the Inside Entertainment a little bit later on. By Inside Entertainment, I'm talking about the sit-down band program, which will be on a little bit later on. And yes, we will be covering that from the Sir Robert Holtman Theatre, so don't worry about that. Hello, my name is Tim from Brass Band, and it really is a pleasure to be broadcasting to you. We had a whole lot of fun just half an hour ago streaming all of the bands down from the ground. We had a roving camera going around getting you high-definition band's eye footage. And I was sort of wondering if we should be moving up here for the mass bands or staying down there. As it turns out, maybe we should have stayed down there. So I actually missed the first mass band going past. Apologies. I do apologise for that. But not to worry. Christmas parade will be starting in about 14 minutes' time. And we'll probably be throwing across to the fantastic commentary supplied with the local knowledge of the local radio station, who will be assisting us with this part of the live streaming. Big day for Team Brass Band. After this, we're off to the Sir Robert Holtman Theatre to cover all eight bands in their sit-down program. Following that, we're on the express car back to Melbourne to be covering the Melbourne Youth Orchestra tomorrow. So plenty of viewing this weekend for you, loyal viewers. A big hello to everyone watching on Facebook. Do hope you're enjoying the quality of the stream. Check it out. We even have multiple cameras, so we're going to get every angle for you. It's going to be pretty spectacular. The sun is on. It's about 22 degrees. I'm going to say it's probably about 29.3 degrees in the sunshine, so I do hope people are wearing their sunscreen. We're expecting somewhere between 17 and 20,000 people to be joining us on the street. And of course, something like 200 million billion people joining us via the internet on the live stream. I think we are almost ready to go. So ladies and gentlemen, before we get underway, I'll just tell you a little bit more about the festival that we're having today. Start off with a message from the Mayor of Mount Gambier, Andrew Lee. So in his words at the start of the program, he writes, "On behalf of the community and council, I am happy to extend my warmest greetings to band persons, their families and supporters visiting Mount Gambier for the 2016 Brass Band Festival. We look forward to a highly successful festival which will continue to showcase brass band excellence in an event of significance and importance to Mount Gambier. The community is indeed grateful that visiting brass bands have agreed to participate in the activities this year. The festival will be an exciting time highlighted by your presence and your involvement in the annual Mount Gambier Christmas Parade. I would also like to convey my congratulations to the Lions Club of Mount Gambier and the organising committee for their continuing enthusiasm and professionalism in planning for the 2016 Brass Band Festival. The festival itself adds to the growing reputation of Mount Gambier being a centre for musical excellence. Welcome everyone once again and thanks for your involvement." So that's what Mayor Andrew Lee wrote in the Brass Band program. And he also wrote something slightly different in the Christmas Parade program. So loyal viewers sitting at home, you can listen to the words and wisdom of the Mayor of Mount Gambier once again, Andrew Lee. The Mayor's message in the Christmas booklet says, "The Mount Gambier Christmas Parade continues to delight the young and young at heart. An abundance of life, colour and music creates an atmosphere of Christmas spirit, which fills the main street of our city, heralding the arrival of Father Christmas and the start of a new festive season. A vast network of people are relied upon to deliver such an experience. The contribution of everyone from major sponsors, Wynn Television, to the media, police, council staff, the Mount Gambier Lions Club Brass Band Festival, many volunteers, schools, sporting community groups, and the business houses who donate vehicles, equipment, materials and services are deeply appreciated by the crowds who flock to see this community extravaganza each year. On behalf of the council and community, I express my sincere thanks to the many who have made a valuable contribution. It's these acts of kindness and generosity that truly depict the spirit of the season. Our Christmas parade is a much-loved tradition, and it is the children who no doubt get the most delight out of it, either as one of many thousands of spectators lining the streets with family and friends, or in costume as part of the parade. Thanks goes to the Christmas Parade Advisor Group for their continued enthusiasm and commitment, sponsors and supporters, the visiting bands, and thanks to you for your participation, support of the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade. Have a wonderful parade day and a Merry Christmas." That's Andrew Lee, the Mayor of Mount Gambier, with words of wisdom for you at home, loyal viewers right around the world. So I might talk a little bit, not about the floats, which we're about to see, because they'll be covered in depth, but we might have a little bit of a chat about the bands this afternoon in the Sir Robert Helpman Theatre from 1:15 p.m. So we'll be starting with Ararat City Band right on 1:15 in the D-grade contest. They'll be followed by Creswick Brass Band at 1:45, Eagle Hawk Citizens Band at 2:15 p.m. and Portland Citizens at 2:45 p.m. All streamed live to you from the Sir Robert Helpman Theatre. The C-grade contest will begin at 3:15 p.m. with Warraparinga Brass Band, conducted by Veronica Bolton, and Mount Gambier City Band with Jared Harrison. Then we have two bands contesting B-grade, City of Greater Dandenong, conducted by Michael Mathers, and Marion City Band with Veronica Bolton. So we should be finishing the streaming at round about 6 p.m. local time, 6:30 for those of you on the eastern states, and probably something like 3:30 p.m. for you over there on the western side of the country. And different times if you're in a different place, the internet is your friend if you'd like to know more about what time it is somewhere else. Some of the major works we'll be hearing this afternoon include The Land of the Long White Cloud, The Mermaid of Zenna, Music for a Festival by Philip Spark, one of the classics. We have Hollywoods by Gough Richard, Oregon by Jakob de Haan, The Four Cities Symphony by Rodney Newton, Oregon once again, and Lake of the Moon, as well as a number of other exciting pieces of music. So I do hope you're enjoying that view of the street. Of course, the parade will be coming down that part of the street in about 10 minutes' time, which we're looking forward to enormously. In the meantime, what's better than a parade? I can think of only a very few things that would be better than a parade. But we are very lucky to have one of those things in front of us right now. A miniature steam train in the pre-parade entertainment. Steam-powered, why walk when you can get a ride? And why pollute the environment when you can use water power to get where you're going? Of course, I'm not exactly sure what's firing that steam there. But a terrific vehicle out in front.
It is Peking Duck and Take Me Over featuring Safia and also a bit of old 55 Christmas for you as well on this Saturday morning as we come to you live from the Jens Hotel balcony, and as we have done for over a decade now, and thanks to Aaron and his wonderful staff here, it is great that we can bring it to you once again. And we are around about probably 15 minutes or so away from seeing them come through here on their way down Commercial Street. We call it down.
Well, we could say travelling in a westerly direction.
That'll do. Mate, is it? What if they turned around one year? No. So heading from Crouch Street through to the Wheel Street corner into Vansittart Park for the unloading. And I can see a few trucks down at the intersection ready to get things underway. And I was going through before trying to work out, and I kept losing count how many schools and things are involved in this today. But there is 52 floats in all, and we've got a lot of schools from around the area. Also a lot of other community groups as well. With some sporting clubs and other community groups, the Men's Shed and obviously the Rotary Clubs, some of the dance studios, Animal Welfare League, Girl Guides. So there's plenty of different community groups involved, along with the schools.
There is one missing.
One missing?
Yes.
Who's that?
Us.
Ah, well, we're Float 53, mate.
That sounds good. I like that.
So, we
are Sanders helpers.
We are here to bring it to you this morning, and hopefully next year we will have a 5GDR float back in the parade again. Why not? We need to get the volunteers geared up, ready to have another go at it in 2017.
I reckon if we twist our coordinator's arm enough, he might give us some funding to do one, all right?
I'm sure that we'll be able to put something together.
Break his leg.
There's some individual entries as well, as there always is in the parade. So we're looking forward to it. Around about 15 minutes away till it gets down here to allow us to call it for you, wherever you might be on this Saturday morning. This is Aha right now. It's Take On Me.
Ladies and gentlemen, loyal viewers, how about that? My name's Tim from Brass Band. We are just waiting very, very patiently for the beginning of this parade. It shouldn't be too far away. We're told it'll be starting at 11 local time. I believe it's just gone 11:06 local time. We've got two camera shots for you, so hopefully they will provide you excellent and possibly even compelling viewing of what's going on today. Hello to everyone joining us via Facebook, and hello to everyone who's joining us potentially on the Brass Band website as well. We know there's a lot of people watching, and we know there have been a lot of people watching right throughout the morning. Now, the parade's about to begin. Sit back, relax and enjoy. 52 floats, 52 of Mount Gambier's most entertaining community groups and supporting businesses making their way down for your viewing enjoyment. We're in high definition. Plug into your big screen TV. Do what you need to do. Sit back and enjoy this. We're going to throw across to the commentary train from the local radio station. Here we go.
You, and it is heading our way. The blue car with the flashing lights is on its way to us, and it is the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade 2016, and it is great that we can bring you this once again from the Jens Hotel balcony. And
a big thanks to Jens too. We must thank them immensely, Nate. They've let us come up here and spawn our cables all over it. So
we've cleaned a few of them up, as we have a ring in now that's destroying our setup, but that's okay.
That's right.
We'll keep the on-air bit going. And as they head on through, we have a massive crowd here for the 2016 Mount Gambier. Oh, it's very difficult to tell. It's about a 5 kilometre stretch that they have to head. So we do have the SAPOL police car coming through, and the first band is the Mount Gambier City Band. Let's have a listen to them. School and the Wind Television sponsorship signage heading through.
The big Year 7 students assisting on the day by carrying the signs and with the band members.
And float number 3 is the Nutcracker, and this is an entry that is popular and has a place on Christmas Eve. And we've got some students here from the MJ Dance Studio on the back of it waving to us as the presents and the Nutcracker, the moving arms of the Nutcracker float, heading on through on this parade day.
Move along to float number 4, the Country Christmas with the community kids from Montebello in the Thanks to, of course, the community kids from Montebello, of course, in Sutton Town Road here in Mount Gambier. And today, all the students, look at them, they're having a ball on there. Of course, highlights a bit. So our trailer today, of course, and they were just all having a ball, sitting on, playing some tunes around the fire. Well, not no fire, but you know what I mean. All singing their Christmas carols.
Alicia and Joe and a few of the others, Caroline and the educators from Community Kids Montebello. They do a great job out there as one of the childcare team here in Mount Gambier. Now we've got the Ararat City Band coming through. These guys have got some clowns juggling, and they've got that much colour.
They were all serious early, and now they've got the uniform on.
Let's have a listen to them.
Have to be serious. We can only see this. A lot of colour from the Ararat City Band. We must welcome them. Of course, St. Martin's Lutheran College in the next one along.
And it's Timmy goes to the Olympics. Got the Olympic rings on the front of the truck. We've got plenty of students. I think they were saying there's about 60 students from St. Martin's Lutheran College on the float this year, and of course the 87 on the train is signifying our area code down here. Resembles something from the island of Sodor, this train.
You should remember that. Come on, we've got kids, we remember that.
Still have to watch it, but it is a great replica and a fantastic effort for the students from St. Martin's Lutheran College to be a part of this parade today.
Flight number 8. Oh, actually, we got back to 7.
Number 7. We've missed one here. We've got 7 as Timmy goes to the parade. But it is the number. We've got the Clydesdale coming through here anyway with the horse. And it is the Chinese fruitless cart and Chinese fruit vendor as that heads on through. It's the Panola Men's Shed that have put this together. And it is a great float. Heading through, sitting in the back, just relaxing is what the boys are doing there.
Move along the float, 8 to Mount Gambier Rock and Roll Club. Of course, it's great to see these. Of course, the rock and roll dance theme, the Christmas decorations, dancing and music. Of course, our club is rock and roll and encouraging the joy of dancing with fun, relaxed, social atmosphere. So you don't have to be... You can be young at heart and still enjoy your dancing. Go and say good day to the Rock and Rollers, the Rock and Roll Club here in Mount Gambier. Of course, great way to spend your evening, Nate.
It is. And our next float to come through is the Tennyson Woods College. Now, this is a huge float every year. They've got more than 100 students participating, and they are bringing joy to the world. The Lord has come. Christmas is about sharing joy with those around us. Everybody in the world celebrates Christmas in a different way, and this gives the opportunity to value and respect the different cultures. Pope Francis declared 2016 the year of mercy. Mercy is taking care of those around us and accepting everyone's differences, and mercy is stepping outside of our comfort zone and bringing joy to others. And Tennyson Woods College has put this dynamic float together from their early learning to the Year 12 co-educational college. And they have about 1,400 students. So we've got nearly 10% of the school probably participating in this float today. And as they come through, we can see a sea of colour. We've got all the different cultural, there's some Japanese or Balinese type people. We've got the Hawaiian floral decorations, and we've got many different cultures all together to celebrate Christmas and the way that they do it all around the world to bring joy to everybody. All the flags down the side of the truck as well from the different countries, and certainly we know Mount Gambier is a very much a multicultural society.
And it's starting to get more and more too, so over the years. We move along to the Wapringa Brass Band. And of course, it says on the back of that flight too, Nate, joy to the world. And I think everyone was one of those things, we all want peace in the world.
We do. And
famous thing at the Miss Beauty pageant, isn't it? Peace on world peace.
Yes, world peace.
Get some votes every year.
Let's have a listen. We've got another Sea of Colour now with another of our bands. As you said before, the Warrabooringa Brass Band coming through. And, of course, our signs are being carried as well by students of the MJ's Dance Studio for all of the floats, the numbers. And let's have a listen to these ladies and gents as they come through. It's the Warrabooringa Brass Band.
And they're a brass of colour too. Gambier, of course, a big contribution to the St. Martin's Kindergarten. And happy birthday, Jesus. And it celebrates his birth.
And it does. And there's a massive birthday cake in the middle of the trailer.
Oh.
The Christmas tree up the front.
I didn't see the birthday cake.
And plenty of Christmas cheer going through with that. Now coming through is Merry Christmas from the Special Olympics SA and the Mount Gambier Tigers Netball Club. As they wander through, just spreading the Christmas message and the bringing a joy of sport throughout the region. And we've got people with all different abilities and, of course, not excluding those in wheelchairs, as we have one heading through in a wheelchair. But it's all inclusive and all part of the Special Olympics SA. And we've got a few on the back of the float as well, and it is a bit of a tree decorated with some balls around underneath it, and a few sitting in the back of the ute to help with the Special Olympics. And it is great that we've sent athletes away from here for various sports at various places around Australia as well with Special Olympics. I know the soccer's been a very big influence for many from our region.
It is indeed, because we can't say any more about the Special Olympics. Of course, it makes them go on to be athletes in the Paralympics. I actually enjoyed watching, not being nasty, but I enjoyed the Paralympics more than I did the normal Olympics, because it was a lot more physical. Of course, what, ever watched the rugby in the Paralympics?
It is.
Changing subject.
It just proves the ability of people, and there is no barriers to stop them from doing things that that they can achieve. And with the right support, they can go on and still live the best life that's possible to them. Of course, a lot of times it's through things that are of no fault of their own. So, yeah, it's great to support those people.
Up to float 13 here today's Mount Gambier Christmas present. Thanks to Triton Tire Centre. Of course, we must thank them very much, and also Gento Hotel for allowing us to come up here. Of course, we look at float 13. Coming Home, it's called. Is this the name of this float? And, of course, I think the Clydesdales there, have they? They have indeed. Oh, look at these. Two Clydesdales, of course, with their trainers, and, of course, the Clydesdale Rescue. And, of course, we take them in, and the Clydesdales no longer wanted to be able to be a card for... We are a non-profit organisation, so there's another volunteer group, a non-profit organisation run by volunteers. And, of course, they are self-funded at this stage. So if you want to be part of it...
Who would want to discard a Clydesdale? They are just wonderful animals.
They are just wonderful animals. And, of course, it's one of those things that... another non-profit organisation taking part in the Christmas pageant. It's great to see these organisations. And here comes the man with the plan.
I think he's just picking up the things that the horses are laying down, doing his part to keep the streets clean and the waterways. So you've got to make sure that you are cleaning up after yourself. But another great effort for the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade. Now we've got a sponsored float with the staff and friends of Exchange Printers, and these guys have got the pirate ship that was built a few years ago, and it is Pirates Are Us, and it is the Exchange Printers Office National and the students from McDonald Park Primary School that are helping this out, and it is celebrating Christmas in a piratey fashion. And the massive pirate ship that has been a part of our parade now for a number of years, and students, as I said, from McDonald Park Primary School as part of this float, and spreading their loot around, as much as pirates don't like to share.
Well, they do share. But, just don't get in their way. Because that is SS Mount Gambier, isn't it?
Oh, something like that. I didn't see a registration tag on it.
It's got
wheels. I don't know what its buoyancy is going to be like.
It might float. Float number 15. Of course, we got the Grinch who's locked up. He's been locked away. Grinch spoils Christmas, doesn't he? He does it every time.
So this is another sporting group. It's the Kung Fu and the Tai Chi, the Kung Jin group that have put this float together, and some of their students and participants from the club are supporting this float this morning, and it is defending Christmas as the Grinch can't take it away from us all, and just another wonderful group of people that put the time and effort in to get their community group together and be part of the Christmas parade.
Here's a dance academy. Love to see these participants. And of course, Christmas around the world. And Christmas is celebrated around the world, and it's some with snow, some without snow. Here in Australia, we don't see that at this time of year. And of course, it is a dance academy run by Principal Maxine Lockwood. The school has now turned 31 years of age, would you believe? And currently has around 120 students and two assistant teachers. So something the kids can get involved in. Christmas around the world is a chance to bring people from all over the world together to celebrate Christmas. It's a time of joy and peace. So this float shows that by joining all of the countries to have a joyful and merry Christmas together. That is float number 16.
The Mariki Dance Academy. And now we've got the Tennyson Wood Drum Corps. These guys were at the Mount Gambier show a few weeks ago. Let's have a listen to them. Day at the beach, and this has got to be the most populated float I think so far. There's definitely more than 100 that it says here as their approximate numbers. I think there's a lot of students from Mulga Street Primary School here. At the end of term three, the reception three students from Mulga Street presented a musical evening at the Sir Robert Hellman Theatre. The evening was a day at the beach. They had so much fun putting it together that they decided to make it their entry in this year's Christmas parade. So Merry Christmas from Mulga Street as they celebrate a day at the beach.
Did we get an invite to the next one?
I don't know. I can't see it. But don't forget the clowns for the City of Mount Gambier Youth Advisory Committee, the Yak Clowns. They're collecting for the Mayor's Christmas Appeal as well. So please donate generously if you are able to this Christmas to the Mayor's Christmas Appeal.
And this one, I want to get an invite to this one. From my old school, would you believe, from Glenbeny Primary School, it is Teddy Bear's Picnic. The Mount Gambier Marketplace has proudly brought us this one. It is flight number 19. And, of course, all the kids, they're going to the Teddy Bear's Picnic. Oh, look at that cupcake. I want that. I wonder if you let me have it. And of course, a big thank you to the Mount Gambier Marketplace for Teddy Bears Picnic. And of course, thanks to Glen Burnie Primary School. My old school, would you believe?
And I would, actually. No, nothing against Glen Burnie. No, nothing at all. I know some students.
Glen Burnie University, thank you, is what Jared Bold always told me.
A few students I know at Glen Burnie and their families. They're wonderful people.
We are.
We continue through right now, and it's Once Upon a Wish. This is Christmas in Fairyland, and it is Christmas Eve. The fairy folk have finished their Christmas preparation. There's lots of magic and fairy dust spread over the world, and tonight it's party night for the Once Upon a Wish, and it is great to see. They've got a heap of coloured streamers. We've got the fairies to bring the wishes true. We've got the elves, and it is fantastic to see them. Faye Cakebread and the team there for Once Upon a Wish and a Christmas in Fairyland.
What's your wish for Christmas? A fine day would be perfect. As we look forward to our next flight here at the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade, of course, 2016. Thanks to our great friends at Trident Tire Centre, located up here at the Gents Hotel. Of course, I must thank Steve, Terry and the team at Trident Tire Centre for proudly letting us be a major sponsor for us today. Christmas in Space, flight number 21. And of course, that is thanks to the Nangwari Primary School. And of course, today, of course, it was the night before Christmas in Space. There you go. It was the night before Christmas in dark, lonely space. Nothing was floating in any place. The helmets were all hung up in the ship with care, hoping that St. Martin or St. Martians would be there soon. The astronauts were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of asteroids hitting the ship popped in their heads.
Even the cow is decorated in some space sort of colours. And
very colourful.
It is an alien riding a push bike on the back, pointing towards Earth. And a lot of effort's gone into that from the Nangwari Primary School. So fantastic for the staff and students up there to put that together. And well worth looking at here this morning in the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade. We're approaching the halfway mark, just a few away from that. But we've got another sea of colour coming through.
You mean he's here?
It looks... No, not yet. But it looks like we've got part two of our Wiggles. Of course, the Mount Gambier City Band earlier on, as Captain America comes through. He's a bit of a roaming entry. It looks like Robin Weston as Captain America, if people know Robin.
We're not going to name and shame anyone, are we?
He was the one that brought the big plane through here a couple of years ago, the one that's up at the Coonawarra.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so we've got Captain America running through, riding through on his bicycle. And
bicycle built for one.
So great entry once again for Robin. But the Wiggles, back onto that. The Creswick Brass Band, they've got Dorothy the Dinosaur and Emma and everybody else as part of their group. Here they are now, just to take it away for us for a little moment.
I thought they meant to be serious. I honestly thought these bands were meant to be serious in their uniform, but no.
Not for this part of it.
Not for this part of the show. Float 23 today's Build a Steam Shovel from the Mount Gambier Community Bank. Approximately about 40 kids are going to be involved in this. And I can remember this, Build a Shovel. Wasn't he a friend of Mr. Squiggle?
He was.
Oh, I remember him.
Upside down. There's Blackboard. Yes. Yeah, hurry up.
Build a steam shovel with Mr. Squiggle, Blackboard and friends. Of course, Blackboard, is he in a good mood? Never. Mount Gambier Community Bank is our local branch of the Bendigo Bank. Our focus is on providing quality services to our community and using our profits to help organisations in our district. And of course, build a steam shovel. I wonder, can you go dig a hole for us?
These guys here will come through now. It's the 48 Army Cadet Unit Drill Team. They're marching in uniform with the Santa hats, of course, and doing their crisscross formation in front of us now. The team comprises of a corporal directing and the drill team cadets marching. And the Australian Army Cadets is a personal development program for young people conducted by the Australian Army in cooperation with the community, which it's designed to benefit and the nation. It's designed to benefit the nation by developing the individual, their community, and the Australian Army. And the 48th Academy parades here from their depot in Shepperson Road.
Float number 25 today in the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade is the Mount Gambier tribute to the Wizard of Oz, Cats and Annie. Oh, have a listen to these. They're getting into it. Oh, we've got the music teacher there. Of course, a musical tribute to the award-winning musicals Wizard of Oz, Annie and Cats. Sit back and enjoy. The toe-tapping tunes. Students will entertain the crowd with their vibrant singing and dancing from start to finish of the parade. And of course, a big thanks to Compton Primary.
They have won the most outstanding float so many times. And
if they don't win it today, I'll eat my hat.
For such a small school to continue to do what they do is just fantastic. Speaking of small schools, this is the Adlair School of Dancing coming through right now. And they've got a classic old fire truck. And their float today is thanks to the MFS as well with their fire truck. And they've got a Scottish white boomers as well, decorated for Christmas. And all other things Scottish, as only a Highland dance school would do, which is fantastic as they do their Highland fling in the main street here of Mount Gambier.
Aye. Float 27 is the 100 years of Cubs Christmas, the first scout group of Mount Gambier. And of course, about 10, I can't see on them. Where are they? Oh, there they are.
Here they come.
They're here.
Now, they've got a special event coming up soon, too. They want 100 kids between the ages of 8 and 10 to be there for the 100 year of Cub Scouts. So if you want to find out more, get involved and go and see the team at Margaret Street for to be a part of the 100 years. They want 100 boys and girls. They've got a big birthday cake. And
they did, and they had that early with the Family Fun Day at the Mount Gambier Airport earlier in the year, of course, when they had the Royal Australian Air Force come in with a C-130 Hercules.
How opportune was that? That's just a plane
that
flying
wasn't
over.
Hercules, by the way. That was just a... That was Santa flying over.
Maybe.
He's late.
Maybe. Coming in late. I don't know whether the microphone picked that noise up or not. But right now, on their way through, we've got another of our bands, plenty of them. And don't forget that the Brass Band Festival is on this afternoon at the Sir Robert Heltman Theatre here in Mount Gambier, that you can get along and be a part of that. We've had them marching earlier in the day.
But that's fantastic.
Coming through now will be the Eagle Hawk Citizens Brass Band.
And are they going to be in uniform? Or are they going to be all dressed up?
They're in the in the. Well, they've got a bit of a summery beach sort of feel about them as they come through. So we'll try and pick up and have a bit of a listen to the Eagle Hawk Citizens Brass Band.
Band members actually gave a young little child down here a high five. Of course, the Eagle Hawk Citizens Brass Band. Of course, they've also got Bendigo. I think they've come from Bendigo Way.
Mostly around that area.
Yeah. Great part of the woods. Great part of Victoria. Flight number 29. Of course, there's the Mount Gambier Central. Of course, the Mount Gambier Community, the Mayor's Christmas Appeal. Of course, don't forget that it's done a lot for Mount Gambier, the Christmas Appeal, if you want to be part of it. So, of course, a big thing. Of course, the Mount Gambier Central has played a significant role each year in supporting the fundraising and raising awareness of the Mount Gambier Community Mayor's Christmas Appeal. The Mount Gambier Central donates 100% of all funds raised throughout the collection of cans, bottles each year to the appeal, along with $1 from every Santa photo session sitting is donated to the appeal as well. So the Mount Gambier Central is proud to be able to assist in combined agencies by bringing Christmas cheer to those less fortunate in our community. And of course, this year, can we make a donation in either person or at the City of Mount Gambier Service Centre with PayPal through the City of Mount Gambier website, which is mountgambier.sa.gov.au.
Continuing through now is our next float, and this is players, kids, parents, coaches and families celebrating the festive season with their soccer. It is, they're dressed and ready to play. It's all in blue. It is the Blue Lake Soccer Club, right from the young ages of under six mini roos right through to their senior age groups, and Blue Lake Soccer Club out at Moleseed Park. And I've got the giant soccer ball, a couple of the girls playing football, soccer, whichever way you call it, and they've just scored the goal. And it is a great family club. If you want to get involved out there, you can contact the club out at Moleseed Park.
I'm sure they're offside.
Blue Lake Big Ray Premiers too in 2016.
Oh, yeah. Offside day, come on. I want to appeal that one. Flight number 31 today is the Mount Gambier Girl Guides. The Polar Express is here. The Mount Gambier Girl Guides are a youth organisation which focuses on the leadership and personal skills development of girls aged between 6 to 17 years of age. And of course today is the Empower Girls. So the mission is to empower girls and young women to grow into confident, self-representing, responsible community members. And of course, the Polar Express is here.
Our next float is the Southeast Animal Welfare League, another community group that has dedicated volunteers that give up their time to support the animals in need. And it is... this year, dogs walking alongside the trailer. We've got a giant dog in the back too, with the kennels,
Scooby,
the Christmas tree, and it is the mascot Fluffy from the Animal Welfare League.
I was close.
And of course, out near the Mount Gambier Airport, they do a great job. And of course, a lot of community people getting behind them, and always great to put a can or two in the bins provided at some of the supermarkets as well in the region.
And it's just also been introduced to the Mount Gambier Hospital too. They bring pets into the hospital to see some of the patients, so it puts a smile on the face of the patients.
And great decorating skills on some of the pooches. I don't know that they're overly happy about it, but they're having a wonderful
day. They're
getting
a walk, okay?
They are indeed. And so they do a great job around our region. The next band to come through is the City of Greater Dandenong. And these guys are looking very, very colourful as we'll try and have a listen. Let's hope they're just not doing this sort of get some real music going through for the City of Greater Dandenong. Let's try and have a listen to these guys and girls.
Of Make-A-Wish Mount Gambier. Of course, it is a volunteer brand. Of course, make a wish for Christmas. What would your wish be if you could have one? Make a wish, Mount Gambier volunteer. Brandy is celebrating 25 years of granting wishes to children with life-threatening illnesses. Make a wish. Wishes gives a very sick children a very... Well, it makes them happy anyway. Hope for the future. Strengthen their faith and challenge them to their illness with joy from their incredible wish experience. So, of course, it is something that we don't wish any kids like that sort of thing, but grant them a wish, it makes them happy, puts a smile on their face, and something that they'll never, ever, ever forget.
And I do know of a family that had a wish granted for their young daughter, who was only about 6 at the time. She's now turned 18 and does extremely well with her swimming and stuff. And it's just been because of the wish that they were granted that got her swimming, and she's gone on from there. So wishes do come true, and it's great that they've been doing it for over 25 years here in Mount Gambier. We've now got Hansel and Gretel coming through. This is a sponsored float from Bunnings Warehouse, and it has students from the Congeron Calisthenics Club involved in the float. And Congeron Calisthenics Club is based down at the Congeron Hall, and has students from around the Congeron region and some from Mount Gambier that enjoy their calisthenics. And Hansel and Gretel, the old nursery rhyme, and the kids, the lollipops, the licorice all sorts, and a sea of colour from the gingerbread house.
Makes you just want to eat that house, doesn't it?
I'm not a big fan of the old gingerbread.
Not big fans of it?
The frosting on the roof might be all right.
And yeah. I can't believe you're not fans of gingerbread. Oh. Moving along to Float 36 of Hype Dance Studio. Dancing at the Christmas Eve party. You ever dance at the Christmas Eve party?
Oh, we have a party every Christmas Eve.
Okay. The Hype Dance Studio?
Not quite as big as this one.
No, not... Oh, wow, we've got a fair few here. We've got close to 100 participants in this today. Of course, a big thanks to Hype Dance Studios. Offers dance for people from all ages. So it's not just any age. You can be as old as you like. But it's from children as young as 18 months right through to adults. So there you go. So hip-hop, jazz, contemporary, ballet and aerobics classes for both fun and competition. So there you go. Something, hey, maybe we could take that up for next year.
The Lions Club of Mount Gambier have joined with Sutton Town Primary School for our next float. And I was in this one many, many years ago.
Now you're showing your age.
Back with the Morak Primary School, and it's still going. I think it's been reinvented a few times, but it's the old woman who lived in a shoe, and this is, again, another of the wonderful children's stories, and the children in the shoe. The woman had so many kids she didn't know what to do, and it is great to see them coming through. Supported, as I said, from the Lions Club of Mount Gambier. I can hear bagpipes.
You hear bagpipes? Oh, Scottish! No, I shouldn't say that. I'd get myself in big trouble saying things like that. Of course, it is the RSL Blue Lake Highland Pipe Band. And, of course, a traditional favourite here at the Christmas pageant, Nate. What is a pageant without a Highland Pipe Band?
Well, we have plenty of brass bands, and this just sort of breaks it up a little bit. So let's have a listen to them as they come through, and this is the Blue Lake Highland Pipe Band.
Because nothing beats the RSL Blue Lake Highland Pipe Band. Now, it's over 100 years old, would you believe? And it's the only functional pipe band here in Mount Gambier. So there you go. Drum major is John Farchin. Pipe major is Barry Ward. And drum sergeant is Ron Telford. But as you say, Nate, it does break it up a little bit with the pipe bands. Of course, we can't go without a pageant with having the RSL Blue Lake Highland Pipe Band. Of course, there used to be two in Mount Gambier once upon a time, if you can remember back that far.
And we have now the Twisted Threads. This is the Wild Woolly Wanderer. And it is a caravan that's got plenty of colour. And the Twisted Threads of many a patchwork quilts and woolen quilts. And she hasn't got enough. She's still sitting in the back there knitting a few more. And it is a textile group that have meetings at the public library each Wednesday morning. It's open to all members from all walks of life, and new residents, they can come and meet people as well and share their knowledge and skills and be a part of that group. Another group that I've had plenty of involvement with is our Next Float.
You know something about this one, do you? I'll give you that piece of paper.
I don't know whether I need the paper or not.
You know everyone, do you?
I've got a few people in this one. It is the Mount Gambier Calisthenics College. They are doing their White Christmas. Look at the castle at the back of the float. A magnificent effort to all that have put this together. We've got Olaf from Frozen. We've got plenty of fairies and angels, and they're celebrating the magic of Christmas with the Frozen characters and the love of dance and song shared by everyone on the float of the Mount Gambier Calisthenics College with Snowflakes and Snowmen, and they operate out of their studios in Alexander Street and have been a non-profit dance school operating since 1970.
Wow. Moving right along to float number 41 as we get closer and closer to that jolly man. What if he's landed it? The Christmas Christmas Memories, I should say, the Mount Gambier Uniting Church. And they've got 20-odd members on their float today. Of course, Mount Gambier Uniting Church, make up of representatives from the church, Uniting Care, mainly music, Interplay, the playground and rest haven, Creative Connections, Craft Group, Uniting Communities, and lots more, of course, the Uniting Church. At Christmas time, memories are made of many reflect on the past year. There's a highs, lows in what we remember. There are lots of laughs, even treats. So there you go. Float 41 today, the Mount Gambier Uniting Church.
And now we've got Humpty Dumpty, thanks to the Lakes Rotary Club and students from your primary school. And I think if he gets a bit more of a rev up there, old Humpty Dumpty might fall off the wall. But certainly Rotary were able to put Humpty Dumpty back together and get him here for the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade.
Oh dear, he's got the comb out. Elvis impersonators are everywhere. One of our visiting bands here today, Float 43, is the Portland City Brass Band.
Now we've got the Mount Gambier Harness Racing Club coming through, and the starting gates are a little bit away from the Greenwald Paceway, but their new livery and everything on their new starting gate vehicle. But we've got the real horses with jockeys on their backs, but the actual trotting horses are, well, not so much horses, but
people, we won't go there.
People in outfits pulling along the young jockeys from the Mount Gambier Harness Racing Club, which is just fantastic.
Hollywood Christmas, of course, one of our next one here, Float 45 today in the Mount Gambier Christmas pageant. Of course, they've got a few of the girls and boys on there having a little bit of fun. Of course, the Ovation Centre is performing arts, started in 2010, so not that long ago, and they specialise in performing arts program classes for students from 4 to 18 years plus, and directed by Jamie Harding and Christy Lee Kalinger. And of course, Christmas event, red carpet arrival for Hollywood movie stars. Paparazzi there to get their photos as well. Can't have a show without a paparazzi, can you?
No.
Where's Liz?
Coming through now is the Gordon Education Centre, and their float is called Why Fit In When You Were Born to Stand Out, and ain't that the truth? And these special students are a part of the Gordon Education Centre, and they're bringing the enjoyment of books and reading. The students are sharing their personal and favourite book characters, such as Dr. Seuss, and it is great to have the family and students from the Gordon Education Centre as part of our Christmas parade. We've got, of course, a sea of colour. We've got
A couple of witches at the back is trading blows.
And elves and all sorts of things coming through. And hello to Leah.
We've let one out. Yeah, apparently she knows me.
I wouldn't know who she was. I've known Leah for a while. And, she does a great job with all that she does with the Gordon Education Centre. So fantastic for them to be a part of the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade.
Float 47 is the Lake City Rod and Custom Club Incorporated. And, of course, the gift under the tree. Oh, wouldn't you love one of these under the tree when you wake up Christmas morning? Oh, I can only dream. The Lake City Rodders Car Club.
You want the car or the...
Oh, the car would be just nice. I reckon I could see myself driving that.
Yeah?
Yeah. I could just imagine it. Oh, I could see that parked in the driveway. You wouldn't want to get it dirty. No. Lake City Rodders Car Club, whose members are active in the safe modification of cars for regular street use. Cars are P48 hot rods and street rods. So 1948, 1965 custom classics. Oh, sorry, I don't want the car towing it. I want the car behind. That is, if you could see this, it's a green, very nice looking car. There's a custom one. Oh, I would love that one. I wonder.
Again, another community group that is out to support this wonderful event. And if you want to get involved next year, obviously there's plenty of time to start thinking about it and be part of it.
It's a 1934 Chevrolet hot rod on the back of that trailer. Newly
about as old as you.
Yeah, that's right. Newly completed, set up for the gift under a Christmas tree. That can be under my tree. Thank you very much.
The Mount Gambier Men's Shed is our next float. They've got a giant Christmas pudding. I don't know whose oven or steam pot that they created that one in, but it is a massive Christmas pudding. It's got the holly on the top, and I wonder who's going to set it alight. Bit of brandy on there and set it alight. Yeah. And it is great that the Mount Gambier Men's Shed
and the chef's at the back there.
Part of it. He's got the stirring spoons.
Yep.
I don't know that they're licking the spoons too much, but they've done their part. And got the Christmas pudding ready for the Christmas feast that awaits.
Have a little bit of pause in proceeding, of course. Thanks to Triton Titan Centre, 14 to 16 Bay Road, Mount Gambier. That's confidence with a capital B. Say g'day to all the team. Of course, we thank them very much for allowing us to help us with our broadcast today. Thanks to Gento Tellers. We move along to Float 49. It's not that far away. The excitement's starting to build. The Marion City Brass Band rolls into town.
I think the workers have been let out of the yard.
And they're advertising how fast they play.
Giant Christmas stocking, which is sponsored by the Mount Gambier Chamber of Commerce, and we've got some kids on here as well that are supporting the chamber, and plenty of presents, and I believe all these gifts are given as part of the Mayor's Christmas appeal as well, and donated by the stores through the Mount Gambier Chamber of Commerce. So a Merry Christmas, and support the local businesses that are part of the Mount Gambier community when you do your Christmas shopping this year.
Moving along to the second to last float, Nate. Float number 51, the big Christmas tree. And that is thanks to the City of Mount Gambier Social Club. And of course, it is a huge Christmas tree. It's got all the baubles on it, all the decorations. No flashing lights on it this year. They have, I reckon they have lights on.
It's not as big as the one down at the main corner. But
it almost
it's
is.
It's a good effort. It's mobile and
it's
doing a great job.
And there's no flashing lights on it, so, of course, big thank you to the City of Mount Gambier, of course, located here in Watson Terrace.
And our final float how did I end up with this one? The Rotary Club of Mount Gambier West, and they've got the reindeer, they've got Father Christmas, and they're spreading the Christmas cheer. He's on the roof of the house, and the gum trees, the windmill, everything out the back for a bit of a bush Christmas landing, and Father Christmas with the moving reindeer. It's who everybody comes to see, and he's made it into Mount Gambier for the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade. He'll be heading down to the Cave Gardens this afternoon after 1 o'clock to be in the party in the park, and it is fantastic to have him as part of the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade. And it's been fantastic to have all of the groups, the bands, the schools, and everybody that's been involved in the setup and the makeup of all of these floats for the Christmas Parade this year. And a fantastic effort once again to Denise and her staff from the City of Mount Gambier, who have obviously been able to put this together and get all the approvals that they need to shut off streets and get people involved. And to all of those that have come out and watched this morning here in the main street, and also to those that have listened to us wherever you might be on the live stream or the radio, it's been great to have your company as well here on this Saturday morning. And we only do it once a year, Brad.
We do.
And it's been another great year. And
well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the Mount Gambier Christmas Parade for another year. My name's Tim from Brass Band. Thanks very much for joining us for this fantastic live stream. What an amazing community event, I reckon. Upwards of 20,000 people. And a big thank you to the local radio station for providing their expert inside local knowledge to the commentary on the way past. Now, loyal viewers, there is more live streaming to come, but we're going to stop this stream for around about 1 hour, maybe a little bit longer, and then we'll be going live just before 1:15 p.m. local time here in South Australia with the Inside Band events at the Sir Robert Helpman Theatre. So please stick with us for that. It'll be a whole lot of fun. Hello to everyone watching us via Facebook. Hello to everyone watching us via the website www.brassband.com. Do hope you have enjoyed this coverage. And please go get a sandwich, have a lemonade, and join us once again probably in about 90 minutes or so for the Inside Sit-Down Band events. The real question is, how quickly can I move all my stuff over there to try and get some good sound and vision? Thanks once again for tuning in. This is Mount Gambier. This has been the Christmas Parade, and we'll see you again shortly.